Well, I think this is as good as it's going to get.
Okay. Well, let's record up.
All right, then. Well.
Not a... Play to the mic. Play to the mic. Get it
some shoulder.
Hey, yo. This guy raps like his parents jerked him. He sounds like Eric Sermon, the generic version.
I'm going to put in something recently. I'm going to put in one of my songs is... Caravan Palace Lone Digger, because it got me into electro swing. That was my introduction into it, so I'm going to put that as number five. Number five of top five songs of all time.
Hey brother, what you thinking? Leave that on record spinning. You feel the rhythm going.
Damn, that sounds good. I feel like I feel like I know that song, but I don't think I do. For my number five, it's a rap song, obviously. But
obviously.
But obviously, like, we grew up with, you know, Eminem and LL Cool J and Snoop Dogg and all these things, and I wasn't really blown away until I heard incredibly fast lyricism to where, like, you couldn't understand them. So I was like, so Tech Nine's Worldwide Choppers came in at number five for sure. Because when I heard how fast you could go, not just in English, but in all the languages around the world, I was like...
Denmark.
I know, right?
Hands down, number five.
I'm going to go with something from my childhood, which probably segues pretty well into the Caravan Palace Lone Digger.
Nice.
I'm going to go with Tank from Cowboy Bebop.
Ooh, that's a good...
It's a classic.
I forgot about
classic
that.
Classic opening song. Jazzy as hell. Oh my god, I love Tank from Cowboy Bebop.
Alright, well then, shit. Number four. Okay, number four wasn't rap. So I'm very proud of it. I know.
Take a drink for that.
To get personal, brother passed away 2014. It's alright. But he actually learned how to play the acoustic guitar. So... And one of the very first songs he learned was "I Want to Know Your Plans" by Say Anything, and it's a great acoustic song.
You're what keeps me believing the world's not gone dead. Strengthen my bones, put the words in my head when they pour out to paper. It's all for you. That's what you do.
I'm going to say my number three song of all time is from my favorite band of all time, Gorillaz.
Oh.
Linkin Park, what the hell's wrong?
I know, I said, you said Gorillaz. I was like, oh.
I ain't happy. I'm feeling glad I got sunshine. In a bag, I'm useless. But not for long, the future is coming on. I ain't happy, I'm feeling glad I got sunshine. In a bag, I'm useless. But not for long, the future is coming on. It's coming on, it's coming on. It's coming on, it's coming on.
No, but Gorillaz and the Demon Days, specifically Clint Eastwood.
Clint Eastwood was on their self-titled album.
Yes.
What is it about that song that really grinds your gears, lubes your tube, jacks you off?
I don't know. I think it would have to be like the chill, relaxing mix with the funky Homo Sapiens rap. is actually just calls to my soul. It's how I felt. It's how I feel when I just kind of relax.
My number three, even though you dissed him, we all had that emo phase, Corey. Get over it. But
it's Evanescence?
No. It's Linkin Park, One More Light. And that's the my top three is the song title, One More Light. Professor passed away. They had released that record like 3 months prior, and then he committed suicide. I mean, that tied into, I never saw the band live. I always put it off going, I'll see him. And, you know, just the whole suicide aspect of things with friends and family that have done that as well. It was kind of like, when I listen to it, it's kind of more of me saying, like, if you're going through suicide, I care. I give a damn. So it's in the feels, Corey.
You know what makes me feel for my number two?
What? What makes you feel?
It's my breakup song. It's when I, it's the song I played like 100,000 times whenever I broke up with a girl.
I can't.
Night.
Is it?
My three doors down.
No, it's not. Is it really?
Yeah.
No.
I would play that song on repeat.
This life really shows your age.
Now once the world floats to the dark side of the moon, but I feel there's nothing I can do. Oh yeah.
I Three Doors Down is still a good band, so.
Well, yeah, I didn't listen to the radio a lot, so, and I didn't have a ton of friends who was into it, so
yeah.
It was more of a personal song for me.
Okay, my number two, which is, it's, rewind, it's kind of hard, like, it's, people at home, when you see these, like, top five or top ten lists of songs or whatever, really give it time, really think back on why they take these spots. You know, he's a troll, he doesn't care, but why? Why would you put them there, in all seriousness? My second one is the exact opposite. I don't know why it's there. But it's The Death of Me by Greaves. I can't tell you why.
I guess I'm sick of feeling like I oughta pack my bags and go. It's all I've ever known. It's all that keeps me focused.
He clearly has pop undertones mixed with rap.
Really?
From The Death of Me, yeah.
Nice. And that's every time that song's on, I always sing all the words. I like have to. I don't know why.
Well, my number one song, I always sing all the words whenever it comes on.
Your number one. What is it? I swear.
Mama. Just kill the man. Put a gun against his head. Hold my trigger now.
Now he's dead.
Mama. Life had just begun. And I'm gonna throw it all away.
Rest in peace.
Goodbye, everybody.
Good song. Good song. Now, why is that? We gotta know why it's number one.
Well, it was played to death in my early childhood. But I think it's because of Wayne's World. Was one of the movies I've watched a lot.
Oh, no, no. Oh, mamma mia, mamma mia. Mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me. For me. For me.
When I was a kid.
Yeah. You don't know how many times, like, how many people don't know that movie, you know?
Too many?
No, like, no one. No one on my side of the family knows it.
Don't put me in a box, man.
Okay, this one is actually, I think you know this song, and it's not the one you're thinking of.
Rap God?
Not even close. But that would have been a good one.
Yeah, Rap really God's good. Amazing.
Oh. Okay, no, this one is actually older. The Way I Am by Eminem. Number one favorite of all time, for sure.
Hey yo, I sit back with this pack of zigzags in this bag of this weed. It gives me the shit needed to be the most meanest MC on this earth. And since birth, I've been cursed with this curse to just curse.
Because at the time, no one had done, you know, it was just a lot of rebellion.
Wasn't DMX kind of that way, though?
Yeah, but DMX came in later. He was like 2003-ish, 2004-ish. So, but not only that, but Eminem being a white cat in a black culture, I mean, that's a lot of risk, you know, especially for a new artist at the time.
Yeah, I can see how you would recognize that being the only Indian kid in the middle of a white neighborhood. You know?
What?
You lived in Utah.
well, you didn't have to bring that out.
Well, isn't you relate to Marshall because he broke into a music career that he is the only white guy besides Vanilla Ice.
And I broke into honest. And I broke into the Mormon community.
Being the only Indian in a good 150 miles.
If you're a native, you're welcome. I was the first. Put that on record.
No, you weren't.
You just said I was.
Yeah, I said you're the only one in town.
All right, well, that includes our list today. So that's what today's episode was, our top five. Hopefully this doesn't creep you out. I don't know if I'll keep it like this. I think I'll go back to the old way. Thank you for
it is the way
it is. I feel like, I mean, I'm glad I can't look at the background, but you know,
I was quoting The Mandalorian. Have you not seen it? All right, put that admission of guilt into it and then lead us out of here.
Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. If you have, please leave a please leave a comment, share with your friends, share with everybody. Thanks for watching. And he's Commander Charmander. I'm Paul Rath King, and thanks for being here. See you guys.
Bye.